is what we know now. And it is purpose is still to operate as the government's most highly classified, top secret laboratory. Why would they admit to the existence of Area 51, especially after decades of silence? The possibility about how it announcement that Area 51 exists is that the real action has moved elsewhere. In other words, the CIA government only felt able to come clean about this because the real secrets have been moved somewhere else. So in a real sense, perhaps, the question isn't so much what's going on in Area 51, but what's going on in Area 52, 53, and 54.
Area 52, 53, and 54. Might there really be other, even more secret locations where the government is continuing to study and replicate extraterrestrial technology?
And in one big place where everybody is doing the research is not a good idea because it would be hard to hide from the general public. So the idea that there might be any single individual here in 51 where they're reverse engineering a spacecraft, now that seems a little bit of an outdated concept. How are we going to do it? How are we spreading the technology and easing out across the country?
Is it possible that the reason government officials reveal the existence of Area 51 is because they want to use it as a decoy? One that takes the focus away from their other, perhaps even bigger operations, and numerous sites all across the United States.
So the fact that people are finding out that Area 51 exists is actually, to my mind, a smokescreen. What's really going on is that you've got all these massive underground facilities. We could take all the really good stuff you don't want anybody to see and stick it up and somewhere else in the blink of an eye.
While the public remains focused on what is or isn't happening at Area 51, could the government be hiding its research into extraterrestrial technology and other strategic sites all across the country? Perhaps the answer can be found by investigating reports of an extensive timeless operation currently underway in the Nevada desert. Stay tuned for bonus footage. Ancient aliens declassified returns.
Fall season is finally here. We must be there for you for any budget and all the celebrations. All you have to promise is to get in on the action. Season starts with a low price promise is already there. Watch out for all the lows today.
Stay safe. Don't. I want you to feel alive.
It's time for the biggest sale of the year on the Sweet Number 360 Smart. This sensor moves and automatically adjusts to keep your money covered. Our smart speakers get 20 minutes more results than you. Don't miss our limited weekend special. Save 50% on the Sweet Number 360 Limited Edition Smart and our site.
It's something every small business owner in the spectrum business has perfected. No concept. When it comes to business internet and phone, you get the best value. No surprise fees like other guys charge, like this mobile fee or cost assessment charge. Nonsense. So get fast reliable internet at 300 megabits per second for only $49.99 per month, plus business phone for $19.99 per month. Just call 833-944-2424.
Is there a
contracts are not signed. Only the 5 contracts are in right now. And 300 meg internet for only $49.99 per month. Plus business phone for $19.99 per month. And no nonsense. No nonsense is here today. Call 833-944-2424 and make the switch today.
Nurse Maria Sabo knows and loves ezekiel and activity of solution with ezekiel. Gold line pure resolution, 24-hour hydration, no paraben size or fragrances.
Rachel Navarre, March 17th, 2018. Just outside the perimeter of Area 51, Georgia Syphilis meets with researcher Wolf McCormick and mining expert Christian Grinnell. They appear to investigate rumors of an alleged tunnel network that lies beneath Area 51.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Wolf and Christian believe this location, the Tempe Mine, is one of several old Nevada mines that have been used to expand operations in Area 51, deep underground.
I'm a miner about 100 miles north of Area 51 here, and I've been mining there since 1992. I also own a mining ball field, so I'm just an avid miner. You know, I search these out. So what can you tell us about Area 51? Area 51, what you see, like on Google imagery, that was the 50s, 60s, and 70s. Since then, they've gone down. Everything they do is underground. And what evidence have you come across as a miner? Elaborate on your idea. They are questioning what they're going down. Or is that dirt going through? Or is it my voice? And they're putting in huge mountains that are deep leaching. By the time they're done deep leaching, it's huge mountains. Which was kind of nothing. Not to get rid of issues. And what should we do? It is a pile of ore up into a large mountain, hundreds of feet high, and they run hoses all the way through it, like every 2 feet, and they teach him mercury and cyanide. And what that does, it'll take others this large and actually just bring them down another way.
Using heat leachers inside the Tempe mine in order to hide the massive amounts of being removed in the course of their digging operations. But if so, how is the government able to conduct such an enormous operation without arousing the suspicion of the local miners?
These mines around here have gold, silver, lead, so any mine would be more than happy to sound more. It's kind of like hush-up mine. I've witnessed this hush-up and dealt with this a lot. Hush-up of the base. The tunnels of Area 51.
It's sort of self-explanatory that the reason why people would go underground is if they're extremely surrounded, there's no interference or less interference.
Exactly, yeah.
As the U.S. military has been expanding its operations in Area 51, not outward, but downward, in order to keep its top secret work even more secret than before.
It is my own belief, based on a lot of good research, that there is most likely a large eyewitness exact web of interconnected underground bases and tunnels that exist.